Welcome to the video news of the week. We are midway through January and the North Country is well into another winter season. This past week saw temperatures dip at night into the double-digit below zero Fahrenheit range, mixed between sporadic snow squalls. During daylight hours, breaks of sunshine made for some pretty scenery, as can be seen here in this footage taken along Route 145 in Stewartstown last weekend. Keeping track of all this on Ben Young Hill in Clarksville is New Hampshire's northernmost transmitter in the NOAA Radio Broadcasting Network. The National Weather Service's National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration broadcasts regularly from Seven Peaks here in New Hampshire. The Clarksville station is WNG 544 at 162.400 megahertz, which broadcasts with a power of 300 watts from Ben Young Hill, named after the town's early settler, Benjamin Young, Jr. Young was born in Wolfboro in 1799 and moved to Clarksville about 1826, when he built a homestead at the foot of the hill bearing his name. The tower, which has a transmitter, which is on Tower Road on Ben Young Hill, is on property still owned by Ben's descendants. WNG 544's automated broadcasts are transmitted in a repeating loop 24 hours a day and can be picked up on conventional scanners.
Tonight, partly cloudy. Cold with lows around 10 below. West winds 10 to 15 miles an hour with gusts up to 30 miles an hour. This is NOAA Weather Radio Station WNG 544 broadcasting on a frequency of 162.40 megahertz from Ben Young Hill in Clarksville, New Hampshire.
Next year, the town of Colebrook will be celebrating its 250th anniversary. For the past few years, a small committee hosted by the Colebrook Area Historical Society has been meeting every few months to make plans for events throughout the year 2020, including a central event around the 4th of July. We spoke with David Collins, who has been helping to spearhead developments with the anniversary plans.
We took the time to really look at, you know, what's the best way to do an event. Now, back in 1970, when they had the 200th, they actually did it on really just a week in August. They kind of took a one big week, and on Saturday was kind of their big highlight where they had a big parade. We actually took and said, you know what, let's take the events that's already going on in Colebrook right now throughout the year. Things like the Winter Carnival, the Dixville Marathon, you know, the Kiwanis Relay, the Moose Festival, different events that are already going on, and kind of see if we can at least tag on to them to make sure people know it's our 250th to do that. And then somebody came up with the idea, and actually I think it was somebody through the Grange that said, you know, why don't you do it on the 4th of July? 4th of July is like an old home day in Colebrook. Everybody seems to show up for the 4th of July. It's a big event. And we said, geez, that's a good idea. And we went to the Kiwanis, because really the 4th of July is kind of their event. Went to them and said, hey, you know, would it be something you'd be interested that we could work with you to kind of enhance and make this a bigger event around the 4th, you know? And the Kiwanis were like, sure, we'd love to do it. We've got some good basis of what we're doing. We're going to start kind of canvassing the community, really, for looking for financial support. We do have a Facebook page, Colebrook NH 250th Celebration. And also there's a Gmail website, colebrooknh250@gmail.com.
Collins also reminisced about Colebrook's last major milestone, the Bicentennial, celebrated in 1970.
You know, back in 1970 when they did it, again, they had that week-long event down in, which would be Keach Field, which you go down behind C.N. Brown, the big field there. They put on a pageant. Ellsworth Bunnell actually wrote a pageant and put on a pageant for that. And they had a huge tent, and that's where they had all really their big events kind of held down. They had, like, they had a public supper and like that. A lot of the interest in Colebrook, a lot of the interest in, like, preserving history and collecting it really came out of this 1970 Bicentennial. A lot of people had a great interest in it. The 200th is interesting. They kind of went on a Victorian-era theme is what they did, and I don't know if we're definitely looking to do that, but if you notice, and everything they did was definitely very much they pulled from the Victorian era. They had things called the Brothers of the Brush and the Sisters of the Swish, which basically what they were was a group like the Brothers of Brushes. They grew a beard, and what they do is the Brothers of the Brush would drive around. They were like the Keystone Cops, and they come at all the business people, and what they do is for a small donation, they bring you down and put you in the stocks, and somebody had to buy you out of the stocks. The 1970 parade, when you look at it, it literally was a smattering of businesses all over the North Country region, and basically people had all types of themes. Like, I can remember my father, his theme was he had basically my sister sitting on, he had a float and all like pink flowers on it, and was Little Miss Muffet sat on her tuffet. So that was it. Everything was a theme. theme on the float. Events were very vaudeville, Victorian era, but the parade itself was kind of a smattering of everything, so it was very interesting the way they did it.
The High Forest Red Cross held its annual After Christmas Turkey Dinner last Friday. Close to 60 were in attendance for the event, with music provided by David Atkinson, David McBurney, Vivian Bell, and Terry Howell. Cold weather has made for perfect ice at the Sawyerville skating rink. Last Sunday, youngsters of all ages were seen on the ice, playing hockey and practicing their skating skills during the chilly afternoon. Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Some snow is on the forecast for the weekend. Friday reaches a high of 26 degrees. Saturday drops to a high of 11, and Sunday rounds out with a high of 3 and a low of -1. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.